Hi all, welcome to OET Speaking and Writing. Today we can discuss an OET role play. Here the setting is a home visit. You are visiting to a 65-year-old man who underwent a left total knee replacement 3 weeks ago. At the time of discharge, he was advised to use a walker for his activities of daily living until his follow-up appointment next month. Your patient is not using his walker since last evening. The spouse is concerned about him. Task: find out why the patient is refusing to use a walker. Educate him on importance of using a walker for his recovery. Help with balance, putting less weight on the operated knee due to weakened muscle. Persuade the patient to use a walker until his next appointment. Explain the risk involved if he doesn't use the walker during the recovery phase. Here, the setting is a home visit, so the details of the patient is with you. The patient is known to you, so you can ask the name of patient during our preparation time. You can ask, how may I address you during our conversation? Let's assume the name is Mr. John. So, you can start your conversation by saying, good morning, is this Mr. John's house? Probably the patient may tell you, interlocutor may tell you like, yes, this is Mr. John's house. Then you can ask, is it right time to talk with you? Then after getting permission from the interlocutor, you can start, my name is Sarah. I'm a registered nurse from the hospital where you underwent your knee replacement surgery. Today, I'm here to check your progress. Probably, as per the interlocutor's card, he may agree with you. Then you can continue by saying, Mr. John, how are you feeling today? Probably, the patient may tell you like, sister, I'm good. Then you can tell him like, I'm glad to hear that. Do you have any troubles like pain, swelling in the knee? Pain or swelling in the knee? Or you can ask, Mr. John, are you facing any problem like pain or swelling in the knee? Probably the patient may tell you like, sister, I am recovering well. Then as per our first task, we need to find out why the patient is refusing to use a walker. So that you can ask question like, do you mind if I ask you one thing? Then you can ask question like, Mr. John, I have noticed that you are not using your walker while walking. Is that right? Probably the patient may tell you like, sister, since last evening, I'm not using the walker. Then we can tell him like, at the time of discharge, you were advised to use a walker at home until your next appointment. Is that right? Then probably as per the interlocutor's card, he may agree with you. Yes, sister, the doctor advised me to use this walker until my next appointment. But now I am okay. Then we can ask him like, may I know the reason for not using the walker? Again, the patient may tell you like, sister, I'm okay. I can walk without using walker. So I thought it's a positive sign of recovery. So I left using it last evening. At that time, as per our second task, we need to educate the patient about the importance of using a walker for his recovery. So you can say like, Mr. John, I do really understand what you are saying, but I would like to make you understand the importance of using walker. You know, Mr. John, it's mandatory to follow the post-discharge instruction for your fast recovery. If you are not following it, that may lead to some adverse effect on your knee. Is that clear? Probably the patient may not agree with you and he may tell you like, I'm doing everything like regular exercise, take all medicines on time and I feel pretty good. So I don't want a walker to support. Then as per our second task, we can explain like, Mr. John, during the post-surgical period, your knee muscles will be very weak and your leg muscle needs some time to regain its strength. That's why we provide you a walker. And this walker will help you to put less weight on the operated knee. It's a preventive and protective measure. That means a walker will help with your balance and prevent fall. Again, the patient may not agree with you. He may tell you like, I don't wish to be dependent on walker. In that situation, we can tell him like, I understand your perspective. Or you can say, I understand your point of view. But let me explain why it is important to use a walker until your complete recovery. Shall I explain? Then, after getting permission from the patient, you can tell him like, Mr. John, you are not going to use the walker for a long time. The doctor will ask you to stop using the walker as soon as he feels that your knees have recovered completely. It is to prevent further complication, so please don't think that it will make you dependent. Again, the patient may not agree with you. Then you can tell him like, Mr. John, I really understand this is difficult for you and it's not going to control your freedom of movement. Instead of that, it facilitates the movement by giving strength on the operated knee. Are you following me? Then as per the third task, you can say like, Mr. John, I completely understand your perspective, but please consider the risk associated with walking unassisted. Without a walker, there is a probability in extension of your healing period. Many people after this knee replacement surgery are prone to falls. Therefore, the use of walker is very necessary to prevent serious fall injuries. Are you following me? Sometimes the patient may agree with you. Then you can tell him like, you know, Mr. John, it's only required until your next visit to the doctor. So please use this few more weeks. It will be really beneficial for you. Then you can wind up by saying, do you have any other concerns? If there is no concerns, you can tell him like, Mr. John, I really appreciate you for your decision. Or you can say him like, I'm happy to hear that. Once again, I assure you that if you follow our instructions, if you use this walker a few more days, you will get a optimal recovery. Thank you for listening to me. If you need any more help, please call me and I wish you a speedy recovery. Thank you, Mr. John. In this way, you can end up your role play.